Fear is an emotion which one feels when one experiences or passes through a dangerous situation or through a situation of perceived threat. It is also considered as a mechanism of the body to protect itself from a dangerous situation or for escaping from the dangerous situation, commonly known as the fight or flight response of the body. However, when exposed to extremely treacherous situations, our body may experience a freezing or paralyzing effect. The fight and flight mechanism of the body was earlier seen as a method of the body to protect it from dangers of the environment. Albeit in today's time, the emotional vulnerability has become so widespread that most of the fears that the humans experience is because of emotions rather than physical dangers, but the body is not able to differentiate between the two. When humans face a dangerous situation, the body begins to function in the manner as if you are facing a situation of the physical threat due to the fight and the flight response system of the body. Due to this mechanism, your body makes a decision of either fighting the danger or fleeing from the danger, depending on the body's capability of handling the situation. Cortisol, the stress hormone of the body, along with adrenaline, is pumped through the entire body in order to make the body capable of facing the dangerous situation. The people who are constantly in the habit of worrying about things or experience prolonged fear due to health, grief, death, divorce, loss, etc., have their brain completely dipped within the cortisol hormone due to the fight and flight syndrome of the body, because of which the brain is not able to unload itself from a load of constant worry and fear. As a result, the architecture of the brain is disturbed and its functioning is impaired and also is not able to control his or her impulses. However, on the other hand, when a person finds itself in a difficult situation or is threatened by something, then fear is contemplated to be the appropriate response of the body. If a person is all consumed by the fear and feels circumscribed by fear, then he or she might be going through feelings of compensation and conflict because of a certain or past complex. One of the best ways to escape oneself from this situation is to find a way to manage and ease out of fear by keeping the fact in mind that it does not affect the mental state and being of an individual. For example, if one fears deep water, then it is not mandatory for him or her to be feared of water, but can merely be a symbolization of other forms of fear, such as that from the stranger, danger, emotional trauma, illness, war, etc. Commonly, people get confused between the feelings of anxiety and fear. However, there is a very basic line of difference between the two. Anxiety is an emotion which does not have any relation with an immediate threat. Fear, on the other hand, is often related to the feelings of aggravating a future condition or its continuation that is normally not suitable for acceptance. Fear is an emotion which is related to instantaneous danger. People are commonly feared by things such as intimacy, examination, driving, needles, failures, people, flying, height, clowns, death, snakes, spiders, water, bridges, terrorist attacks, criminals, war, gang violence, ghosts, demons, cockroaches, enclosed spaces, tunnels, future, or being alone. People who believe highly in religious thoughts are the least hindered by the fear of death. When these people were asked to give an explanation for this, they have made their revelation about their belief in the concept of the afterlife. However, each and every individual alive on the planet Earth suffers through the feelings of fear of death. Fear of the unknown is yet another new concept of fear that makes the people worry about what might happen 10 years after the present time. Some people are found to be reluctant in taking a decision due to the fear of what might happen in the near future. Psychologists classify fear as an emotion, but it constitutes a part of a very basic emotion and hence can be contemplated as a simple feeling. If emotions are believed to have been comprised of the reactions of the body and the feelings, then fear, would form the feeling component of the anxiety, just like it has been mentioned in the book of the Psychology of Emotions. It is preferable to refer to fear as a feeling rather than as emotion. However, for attributing value of feeling or emotion to fear, it is important to understand the difference between the two. Emotions are defined as complex mental and physical processes, as emotions are comprised of the feelings which form the mental or the psychological component of emotion, and of the bodily reactions, which are also referred to as the physical reactions. From this, feelings can be concluded to be an important part of emotion. When discussing feeling, these are nothing but the mental or psychological reactions of the body and have no relation to physical reaction. For example, a person who fears the examination center will show bodily reactions such as flushed face, dilated eye pupils, rapid beating of the heart, etc. However, he or she may not show any bodily reactions simply due to the oblivion of the feeling factor of the emotion, but not as intense as that for anxiety, which requires the occurrence of a minimal amount of bodily reactions. Like, for instance, a person has stage fright, and while performing an act over the stage, he or she appears to be all calm and composed, but somewhere internally he or she may be fostering the feeling of fear as some sort of uneasiness. Hence, fear can be contemplated to be both an emotion and a feeling. But fear cannot be understood or detected entirely if expressed as a completely subjective feeling, not accompanied by any visible physical reaction, just like in fear, as in emotion. On the contrary, anxiety is described as an internal emotion which arises within an individual due to a self-comprehended internal threat, which is not present in the external environment. Each and everyone is feared by some or the other thing in their lives. During a frightful situation, or when exposed to threatful stimuli, the central and peripheral parts of the brain respond to the stimuli during the process of fear. The important parts of the brain involved in the process of fear are sensory cortex, thalamus, hypothalamus, amygdala, and hippocampus. It is the thalamus which is responsible for deciding the location for sending the sensory data received by the brain. The data is decoded and interpreted by the sensory cortex. Hippocampus is the part of the brain which is referred to as the storehouse of past memories and past experiences. It also processes a stimulus that helps in setting up a relation between the present stimulus and past memory. Amygdala interprets all the emotions related to the site of the stimuli and assesses an upcoming possible threat and stores up all the fear memories. It is the amygdala that works the most effective during the process of fear. Hypothalamus produces the hormone which activates the fight or flight mechanism of the body. During the fear process, the body creates certain physical responses such as increased breathing rate, increased blood pressure, faster heartbeat, skin sweats and sensations in various parts of the body such as head, legs, stomach, chest or hands. The concept of the psychology of fear differentiates fear as conscious and fear as an unconscious, fear as emotion and fear as a feeling, fear as anxiety and fear in phobias, and lastly, fear with bodily actions and fear without bodily actions. This is done as it is important for the psychologist to be able to understand as of why the feeling of fear emerges and what are the therapeutic directions for fear. The feeling of fear can generally be considered as a feeling of unpleasantness or can be considered as a much complex emotion like anxiety and externalized fear. Fear may arise with respect to a particular situation or towards a specific object, which is termed as a phobia. Phobias may be of enclosed spaces, like lifts, crowds, height, water, or any other thing or situation often accompanied with much severe bodily reactions. Fear can be expressed as a mix of extreme emotions and minimal bodily reactions, or vice versa, or anyone or both these on the extremes. Fear can be recognized as simply a general feeling or as anxiety or phobia.